Hey, once again, this is Ken Jobst taking a closer look at our midweek message for the week just passed. And that message was entitled, Living Into God's Promises. Living Into God's Promises. And the scripture passage that was the focal point for this was Hebrews chapter 6, verses 13 through 15, which very quickly talks about God making a promise and then Abraham obtaining the promise. So there's the action of God making the promise, and then later Abraham obtains the promise. Two different ideas. So there may be a time lag, is what the scripture is telling us, between God's making of a promise and our obtaining the fullness of the promise. Hebrews gives the illustration of Abraham, who was promised two things by God. He was promised land and he was promised descendants. Well, as it turns out, he comes to be 137 years old. He still doesn't have any land. Where's the land coming from? Well, it turns out the land is going to be the burial plot. The beginning of the land is going to be the burial plot where Abraham buries his wife, Sarah. It's a small beginning. But Abraham took action to be sure that God's promise would be able to come about in his life. He didn't put his feet up and wait for God to do all the work. Abraham got involved. What about the promise of descendants? Well, as it turns out, Abraham's son Isaac was 37 years old and he still wasn't married, still had not met a wife. So Abraham takes it upon himself and says, look, I'm going to set my son up for success in finding a mate. And he does that throughout the book of Genesis chapter 25. So in each case, in the case of God's promise of land and in the case of God's promise for descendants, in both cases, Abraham was not passive. Abraham was actively engaged in doing this. Watch, creating the circumstances through which God's promise could come to pass. And that's all of our responsibilities. God has a promise on your life. You probably are aware of it in some, you know, broad strokes. But as we work and as we are faithful to create the setting for the promise to be fulfilled, we'll see that God does indeed bring about the fullness of that promise. And don't be afraid if it starts out with little things, because when God sees our faithfulness in the little things, we're entrusted with even greater things. Well, once again, with a closer look, this has been Ken Jobst. God bless you. I hope you have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.